অনেকদিন পর আবার ফেরত এলাম, মাঝখানে আমফানের ঝড় ঝঞ্ঝা সব গেল। আশা করি সকলে ভালো আছো, পড়াশোনা অবশ্যই মন দিয়েই করছো। তো স্ট্রেট লাইন সামান্য বাকি আছে কিছু, তো ওটা আজকে ক্লাসে করবো। তো শেষ যে স্ট্রেট লাইনের ক্লাসটা করেছিলাম তারপরের একটা অঙ্ক করছি, যেটা একটু বড় ছিল বলে সেদিন শেষ ক্লাসে করিনি, আজকে করা যাচ্ছে। কোশ্চেন যেরকম, দ্য ইকুয়েশনস অফ দ্য লাইন্স এ বি অ্যান্ড এ সি অফ ট্রায়াঙ্গেল এ বি সি আর ইস দিস, দ্যাট ইজ আর গিভেন। ইউ হ্যাভ আ ট্রায়াঙ্গেল এ বি সি, ইন দিস ট্রায়াঙ্গেল এ বি সি উই হ্যাভ ইকুয়েশন টু দ্য সাইডস এ বি অ্যান্ড এ সি আর 3x plus 4y plus 9 equals 0. This is 3x plus 4y plus 9 equals 0. And 4x minus 3y. This is 4x minus 3y plus 16 equals 0. You have that equations of the sides AB and AC given by 3x plus 4y plus 9 equals 0 and 4x minus 3y plus 16 equals 0. The third side passes to the point D 5,2. Third side is BC. This passes to the point 5,2 and BD is to DC is 4:5. It is given that D divides the line segment BC internally in the ratio of 4:5. Now you are asked to find the equation to the third side. You have to find equation to the third side BC. Now look, you have equation of the side AB. So you can take any point on the straight line AB, as if you take x equals lambda. Suppose you take x equals lambda in equation of the side AB, then you get 3 lambda plus 4y plus 9 equals 0. So you get y equals to minus 3 into lambda plus 3 by 4. So you can consider coordinates of B as lambda comma minus 3 by 4 into lambda plus 3. This is coordinates of the point B. So you can you have to write in this way. You write, we can take any point on the straight line 3x plus 4y plus 9 equals 0 as this. Then let us consider coordinates of the point B as this. Similarly, we take any point on the straight line AC. In the similar way, we take x equals to mu there and we get 4 mu minus 3y plus 16 equals 0. So you ultimately get 4 into mu plus 4 by 3. So we take coordinates of the point C as mu comma 4 by 3 into mu plus 4. This is coordinates of the point C. Now let us use the fact that D divides BC internally in the ratio of 4:5. So write in this way, the coordinates of the point D, which divides line segment BC internally in the ratio 4:5 are given by 4 into axis of C, that is 4 mu plus 5 lambda by 4 plus 5 comma, then 4 into this, that is 16 by 3 into mu plus 4 plus, no, here is minus
So this will be minus minus 5 into this, that is minus 15 by 4 into lambda plus 3 by 4 plus 5. Let us simplify it. 4 mu plus 5 lambda by 9 comma, let us multiply this numerator denominator by 12, then we get 64 mu plus 64 for the 256, then minus 12, so 45, minus 45 lambda minus 45 3 is 135 by 9 into 12, 108. So we ultimately get 4 mu plus 5 lambda by 9 comma 64 mu minus 45 lambda plus 516325112121 by 108. There is no common factor to cancel this. Now this point coincides with the point 5,2. So we have the equation. This is equals to 5,2 given. So we ultimately get 4 mu plus 5 lambda by 9 is equals to 5, and 64 mu minus 45 lambda plus 121 by 108 is equals to 2. This gives 4 mu plus 5 lambda, 9 times the 45, and here we get 64 mu minus 45 lambda, 216 minus 121, 156, 95, so this equals to 95. So we get these two equations. Now we have to solve lambda and mu. We have the equations 4 mu plus 5 lambda minus 45 equals 0, and 64 mu minus 45 lambda minus 95 equals 0. Now solving these two equations by the method of cross multiplication, we have mu by lambda by 1 by. So you get mu by 5 into minus 95, minus 47. Here it will be minus 45 square. Then lambda by 64 into 45 minus 64 into 45 and then plus 4 into 95 and then 1 by this will be minus 4 into 45, that is 180, minus 64 into 5, 320. So we get 45 square, or we can take which is 45 square. 45 into 45. This will be 2025. 2025 plus 475 minus 2500. Lambda by this will be 4 into 95. 4 into 95. This means 380. And this is 64 into 45. Let us take 20 common here. Take 20 common. So 5 from this, 4 from this, 519 minus 5 from this remains 9, 4 from this 6, 69 the 144. Is equals to 1 by, here it becomes 320, 400, 500. So you get mu equals to 5, mu equals to 5, and lambda equals to 144 minus 19, how much? 144 minus 19. 125 minus 125 into 20. So this will be minus 250 by minus 500. This is also 5. So we get mu 5, lambda 5. After getting this, we can find coordinates of B and C. Now, coordinates of B will be lambda 5, so here 5, 5 plus 3 8, 4 plus 8 minus 6. Coordinates of B is 5 minus 6, and coordinates of C will be 5, 5 plus 4 9, this is a 9, 3 4 12. Coordinates of B is 5, minus 6, and that of C here 5, 12. Okay, you are asked to find equation to the third side, that is equation to the side BC. Now, equation to the side BC is 2.1, y plus 6 by x minus 5 equals to 12 plus 6 by 5 minus 5. Okay. This is a line parallel to here x is constant, x equals 5. So, its equation will be x equals to 5. Or rather, write directly, you can say that as abscissa of the points B and C are same, both are 5. So, you can say equation to the side BC is x equals to 5. Okay. Now, let us go to the part angle bisector problems. Suppose we have two straight lines. Let us name them AB and CD. So when we are given two straight lines, then there exist two angles between them. If the straight lines are mutually perpendicular, then both the angle will be right angle. But if not, that is not the case, that is they are not inclined at an right angle, then one angle will be acute, another angle will be obtuse. Here if they intersect at the point say E, then here angle B is acute and angle BC is obtuse. So we have two angle bisectors. One is this, another is this. Say one bisector is PQ, another bisector is RS. So how do we find their equations? For this, let us consider any point. Let this point be S, because any point we always take as point P. Let us take P, H, K be any point on any one of the angle bisectors. Now, from previous geometry we know any point lying on the angle bisector is equidistant from the two arms of the angle. That is, if you consider this is as PM and this is as PN, you always have PN equals to PM. Now, suppose equation to side AB is A1X plus B1Y plus C1 equals 0, and that of CB is A2X plus B2Y plus C2 equals 0. Now, perpendicular distance PM, this will be mod of A1H plus B1K plus C1 divided by root over of A1 square plus B1 square unit. And that of the perpendicular distance PN, this will be mod of A2H plus B2K plus C2 divided by root over of A2 square plus B2 square unit. Now, according to the property of angle bisector, we must have PM equals to PN. That implies PM square equals to PN square. That implies what will PM square? PM square will be, or keep it, PM equals to PN. Otherwise, we will not get the two angle bisectors separately. So, PM equals PN, so we have mod of A1H plus B1K plus C1 divided by root over of A1 square plus B1 square equals to mod of A2H plus B2K plus C2 divided by root over of A2 square plus B2 square. So now we can write equation to the locus. Equation to the locus of the point PH, K is given by, we know we have to just replace H by X and K by Y. So we get mod of A1X plus B1Y plus C1 divided by root over of A1 square plus B1 square is equals to mod of A2X plus B2Y plus C2 divided by root over of A2 square plus B2 square. So if we remove modulus sign, so then we ultimately get equations of the angle bisectors as A1X plus B1Y plus C1 divided by root over of A1 square plus B1 square is equals to plus minus A2X plus B2Y plus C2 divided by root over of A2 square plus B2 square. So, if we consider plus, then we get one bisector. If we consider minus, then we get another bisector. Now, our problem is to detect which one is the bisector of acute angle and which one is
the bisector of obtuse angle we will discuss later. Now write down
a note under this. Detection of the bisector. Detection of the bisector of the angle containing the origin. How do you detect this? For this, among these two signs, we have to take that particular sign which makes sign of C1, C2 same. So, the sign among plus or minus on the RHS which makes the sign of C1 and C2 same corresponds the bisector of the angle containing the origin. Okay. This is the process we take to detect the bisector of the angle containing the origin. That is, among these two signs, we have to take plus or minus, which makes the signs of C1, C2 same. That particular bisector is the bisector of the angle containing the origin. Now let us do some problems. That will be more beneficial to you. Suppose we have the equations 12x plus 5y minus 4 equals 0 and another one is 3x plus 4y plus 7 equals 0. This is number 1, number 2. 12x plus 5y minus 4 equals 0 and 3x plus 4y plus 7 equals 0. Now you are asked to find the angle bisector containing the origin and the angle bisector bisecting the acutane. Now how do you proceed? First, in the first step we have to find the two angle bisectors. So for this we have in this way. Right. Equations to the angle bisectors. Of the angle. Between 1 and 2. Are given by 12x plus 5y minus 4 divided by root over of 12 square plus 5 square is equal to plus minus within bracket 3x plus 4y plus 7 divided by root over of 6 square plus 4 square. Now just I have said that you have to take among these two signs plus or minus which makes the signs of constant terms same. Now look, if you take plus from this side, then you get plus 7, but here it is minus 4. So their signs are different, but if you take minus sign on the right hand side, it will make their signs same, because then you get minus 7, this is minus 4. So the sign minus, it makes sign of the two constant terms same. So you write in this way. Now equation to the bisector of the angle containing the origin is given by this is 13, so 1 by 13 12x plus 5y minus 4, and this is 5, so this will be minus 1 by 5 into 3x plus 4y plus 7. Now just simplify it, you get 60x plus 25y minus 20, this will be minus 39x minus 52y minus 91. So you ultimately get 99x, 52, 57, 77y plus 91, that is plus 71 equals 0. This is the equation to the bisector of the angle containing the origin. Okay? This is the equation to the bisector of the angle containing the origin. You have detected it. Next, we have to detect the bisector of the angle containing the bisector of the acutane. So how do we proceed? For this, we have to find the equation of the bisectors separately. This is one bisector. Say I am writing it here. 99x plus 77y plus 71 equals 0. Say this is number 3. Next, equation to the other bisector. Other bisector, this will be 5 into this, that is 60x plus 25y minus 20 is equals to the number. Here you have to take plus sign. 13 3 is a 39x, 52y, 13 7 is a 91. So you ultimately get 21x minus 27y minus 111 equals 0. 21x. So this is divisible by 3, so just cancel by 3, 3 7 is a 3 9 is a 37. So we get 7x minus 91 minus 37 equals, we are writing this here, 7x minus 9y minus 37 equals to, this is number 4. Now I am using this. Again go to the diagram. These are the two given straight lines. One is say AB, another is say CD, and these are the two bisectors. Say AB is represented by 1, CD is represented by 2, and anyone say this is 3, this is 4. Now we have to detect which one among 3 and 4, which one among 3 and 4 bisects the acutane. For this, we have to choose any one straight line from the given two straight lines and any one straight line from the obtain two bisectors and to find the angle between them. Then we have to choose on the basis of simplicity of the equation. Look, here equation 2 is more simple than 1 because here numerical coefficients are smaller. Similarly, in 4 numerical coefficients are smaller. So we choose equation 2 and equation 4. So let us choose equation 2 and 4 and let the angle between them be theta. This is equation 2, this is 4. So we have considered this angle as theta. Now, slope of 2 is same 1. Slope of 2 will be minus 3 by 4 and slope of 4 is n2 equals to slope of 4, its slope is 7 by 9. Now we have the formula tan theta equals to mod of m1 minus m2 by 1 plus m1 into equals to mod of m1 minus m2 minus 3 by 4 minus 7 by 9 by 1 plus their product minus 3 by 4 and 7 by 9. Just calculate it. Minus 55 by 36. There it will be 36 minus 21 by 36. If you multiply by 36, then you get 55 by 15 modulus, so it is a negative sign, 5 11 5 3, we get 11 by 3. This is more than 1, which suggests that theta is more than 45 degree or pi by 4. This implies theta is more than pi by 4. This implies theta is more than pi by 2. Look, if this is theta, then this is also theta. So you get 2 theta more than pi by 2. That is, your selected, if this is theta, then this will be theta. Because this is the bisector. When theta is more than pi by 4, then 2 theta is more than pi by 2. So this is obtuse angle, so your selected bisector 4 is the bisector of the obtuse angle. So obviously the bisector 3, this is the equation to the bisector of acute angle between the lines. So now we will write the equation to the bisector of the acute angle is 99x plus 77y plus 71 equals. This is the process to detect which bisector bisects the acute angle and which bisector bisects the angle continuing the origin. Now, take some problems as your homework. You will do it at your home to make the concept clear and permanent in your mind. Find the equation to the angle bisectors of the angle between the lines. Number 1, 5x plus 12y minus 3 equals 0. 5x plus 12y minus 3 equals 0. And 3x minus 4y. 3x minus 4y plus 1 equals 0. These are the given two straight lines. we have to detect the angle bisector which bisects the angle containing the origin and the angle bisector which bisects the acute angle. So your answers are 32x plus 4y plus 4y minus 1 equals 0 or equal to 1. This is origin containing angle. Origin containing angle bisector. And the second answer is x minus 8y plus 2 equals 0. X minus 8y plus 2 equals 0. This is acute angle bisector. Acute angle bisector. Okay. Homework number 2. The given lines are 3x plus 4y. 3x plus 4y plus 1 equals 0 and 8x minus 6y minus 3 equals 0. Now your answers are 14x plus 2y 14x plus 2y equals to 1. This is origin containing angle bisector. Another one, 2x minus 14y equals to 5. This is not written here, maybe acute angle or maybe opposite angle, you have to check it. Okay, so these two remains as homework. So let us complete today's class here. In the next class we will come with the chapter circle, that is also an important chapter of quadrant geometry. Till then, goodbye. Bye.